hurling a pilot out of a plane that's traveling at hypersonic speed. Totally believable, or nothing but a Top Gun trick? In Top Gun, Maverick, the title character pushes a prototype Darkstar hypersonic jet too far. As the aircraft comes apart, he is forced to eject. Maverick makes it through the ordeal completely unscathed, which you can probably put down to Hollywood bending the laws of reality to avoid killing off a title character early on in a movie. But is there a chance you could eject from a plane at 10 times the speed of sound and live to tell the tale? Astrophysicist and presenter Neil deGrasse Tyson doesn't seem to think so, having tweeted, "At that airspeed, his body would splatter like a chainmail glove swatting a worm. Just saying." But is there a chance that Tyson is wrong, and that a real-life Maverick could actually make it?
He's the fastest man alive.
Well, let's get one thing out of the way. You can't eject from an aircraft at Mach 10 without first being in an aircraft that is traveling at Mach 10. A US Air Force pilot is highly unlikely to find himself in such a scenario, because the United States military doesn't have an aircraft capable of traveling at those speeds. The fastest military plane currently in service is the Lockheed SR-71 Blackbird, which is capable of climbing to a height of 85,000 feet and traveling at a speed of 2,200 miles per hour, or just over Mach 3.
I feel the need for speed.
The Blackbird has its own ejection system, which was once used at Mach 3 when a sharp turn coupled with some system malfunctions caused the plane to break apart at 78,000 feet. And one of the men relying on it, Bill Weaver, survived to tell the tale. But the man with whom Weaver was flying, Lockheed specialist Jim Zweyer, wasn't so lucky. He was killed instantly after suffering a broken neck. Ejecting at extremely high speed and altitude isn't like taking a parachute jump. There are a number of factors that could kill a human long before the 16-mile fall gets its chance. G-forces are an issue, but it's possible for a human to survive over 46 Gs in extremely small bursts. Sustained G-force is a different issue, with fighter pilots requiring specialized suits to stop their blood from being forced down to their feet when they reach 9 Gs. A minute at 10 Gs would be enough to kill a person who wasn't wearing special gear. Weaver was wearing a specialized suit at the time of his accident, which provided oxygen and pressurized the suit to prevent his blood boiling in the low atmospheric pressure. The pressure in the suit also provided some protection from the G-forces Weaver encountered, as well as the freezing temperatures you'll find at that altitude. Low pressure also means there's no resistance to stop someone tumbling at high speed, so the ejection system included a stabilizing chute. That day, the main chute deployed at 15,000 feet, bringing Weaver safely back to Earth. There's one other ejection method that might keep a person safe when escaping a plane at high speed, high altitude, or in other dangerous conditions. Ejection pods aren't much bigger than standard ejection seats, but will totally encapsulate a person before jettisoning them from the aircraft. The inside of the pod is pressurized. The hard shell protects the person inside from things like debris, and it prevents most injuries to flailing limbs.
Together, they could see the escape capsule taking its long-awaited and richly deserved place as a major advance in aeronautical safety.
The pods were originally designed for the B-58A Hustler, a supersonic bomber capable of hitting speeds above Mach 2. While the pods would usually be closed just before a crew needed to bail out, they could also be used in other circumstances. If the cabin lost pressure, for example, crew members could close the pods and still maintain limited control of the plane. Each capsule contained a small window allowing the person inside to see what was going on beyond their safety pod. And it even featured a control stick so that pilots could still fly the plane right up until they actually ejected. If the pod was closed, but the situation had been resolved before anyone actually had to eject, it could be reopened using a lever near the passenger's feet. Like other ejector seats, the pods had parachutes that would automatically deploy and a built-in survival kit to keep everyone going until a rescue mission could be mounted. If you simply ejected at Mach 10 using a regular jet's ejection system or even a pressure suit, you would not survive. But it's not the ejection part that would cause an issue, and contrary to what Neil deGrasse Tyson has said, you're unlikely to splatter. As former NASA astronaut and US Navy Captain Scott Kelly explained in a tweet, the altitude you'd need in order to reach those speeds would actually work in your favor. The pressure at sea level would tear you to pieces at Mach 10, But the extremely thin atmosphere at which a hypersonic jet is operating wouldn't rip you to pieces. So you may actually survive the ejection, but getting back to Earth is a different matter. At the altitude the jet would be traveling at, you'd basically have to re-enter the atmosphere to get back to ground level. This essentially puts you under the same strain that space shuttles are designed to survive. In a suit like the one that saved Bill Weaver, or in a standard ejector seat, you'd probably be burnt to a crisp. In a specialized ejection capsule designed to survive that exact situation, you would probably be fine as long as the capsule didn't malfunction. People have also survived dropping from the edge of space in special suits. Felix Baumgartner set a world record in 2012 when he plummeted from close to 128,000 feet, breaking the sound barrier on his descent. Alan Eustace, a pilot and former Google executive, went on to break that record, again in a specially designed suit. The suits both space jumpers wore may not be practical for piloting an advanced aircraft, however, as they were essentially designed to keep someone alive while they fell to Earth from a large balloon. However, between those suits and concepts like ejection capsules, it's clear that technology is there to ensure a real-life maverick has a good chance of coming home in one piece.